Hi guys, so Ming Tawid here from smartpinoyinvestor.com, and today we'll talk about the idea of index investing. So index investing is one very passive approach to investing in the Philippine stock market, and this is very ideal to people who simply want to make money by doing long-term investing but really don't have the time to monitor the market on a day-to-day basis. So if empleyado ka who's got a full-time job, or you are an OFW working sa ibang time zone, or you are a business entrep working on your business, then this may be a good investing strategy for you. So today we'll start with an idea of what an index is, ano yung kanyang importance, ano yung kanyang gamit, what are the advantages and disadvantages when you do index investing na tinatawag. So, bakit madalas siyang nababanggit as recommended strategy, at least for long-term investors? And finally, what specific strategies you can use with index investing, whether you are a newbie or an experienced investor? So, if wala ka pa namang account, di ka pa nag-start mag-invest, you can watch our previous video, How to Open a Trading Account. So, this is actually the first step if you wanna invest in our own Philippine stock market. And once you have your trading account ready, you can follow our next video to have a basic understanding of how online investing in stock market works. And for other lessons for newbies, so you can download your free ebook for beginners. So just go to this website. And for more practical videos, so you can follow our YouTube channel. Make sure to subscribe and click the notification bell so that you get updated for every new lesson that I'll be sharing with you guys in the future. So with that said, let's go back to our lesson for today, index investing. So first, let's talk about the concept of market index in general. And yung first obvious question we ask is, what is an index as applied to financial markets? So an index essentially is a measure to track the price performance of a group of assets. So when we talk about an index, we're actually talking about a group of assets. And in this group, the members normally share a common trait. So it could be that, for example, these assets belong to the same industry, or they are considered to be the biggest companies in terms of market capitalization, or pwede ring these assets belong to a specific country. And the way this index moves or perform in a given period is normally used as a benchmark for comparison to other investment funds. And lastly, we use this index, its value and its trend, as a gauge or indicator of the general investor sentiment. So for example, if the index tracking our Philippine stock market is going down, then it mainly tells us that the investors as a whole is not positive about our market in general. So bakit mahalaga yun? Well, because fund managers of huge investment funds, both local and abroad, are actively following the index. So if they think there are valid reasons why bumababa yung index, then they will think twice investing their funds in our local market, and mahirap pang umakyat yung ating stock market. So around the world, we have different market indices. So in the Philippines, we have our main index, which is called PSEI, or Philippine Stock Exchange Index. So this is used to be called PHSIX and also called Philippine Stock Composite Index. So in the case of PSEI, it is composed of the top 30 companies we have in the Philippines in terms of company size or market capitalization and liquidity. So in the US, they have several market indices dahil sobrang laki ng kanilang stock market, and one of their indices is the Dow Jones, or Dow Jones Industrial Average, or the Dow, which consists of the top 30 companies they have. And then another index that they have is the S&P 500, tracking the top 500 companies in their stock market. Again, in the Philippines, we have top 30 companies in our index, and we can see yung exact list ng member companies sa PSE website. So as of today, October 7, 2020, so these are the 30 member companies we have in our index. So you will see here familiar brands. So meron tayong BDO, PLDT, Globe, SM, Ayala. And then we have some consumer stocks like Jollibee and Pure Gold. And we can also track these indices sa several financial websites such as Bloomberg. So ito yung Dow Jones, Nasdaq, and S&P 500. Or we can also track them in our local broker's online platform. For example, if you are a COL financial user, so meron kayong makikitang markets tab sa homepage. And you will see here yung different market indices. So yung Hang Seng Index is the stock market index in Hong Kong, and we have Nikkei 225, which is the stock market index for the Tokyo Stock Exchange, which measures the performance of the top 225 large publicly owned companies they have in Japan. So other countries, meron din silang sariling stock exchange index. So as mentioned, we have PSEI, which is our main index, which covers the 30 biggest companies we have. But we also have a much broader all shares index na tinatawag, which covers all companies listed in our stock exchange, meaning to say all of the stocks traded in our stock market are included in the computation of this all shares index. And then we also have the six subsectoral indices, which include financials, holding firms, industrial, property, services, and mining and oil. So just by looking at these indices, you get an idea where the people are investing or trading. And where do we see these indices? So makita natin yan sa PSE website, pse.com.ph, or you can also check them in your online trading account. So if you are a user Nicole Financial, you should be able to see it under quotes, market information, and then goes under summary. So ito yung main index, PSE composite, and then you have the all shares and the six sectoral indices. And then kay First Metro Securities, they have this page under quotes showing the market indices. And just some more interesting facts about PSEI. So again, this is composed of the 30 largest and most active publicly owned companies we have, which we also call blue chip companies. And then ito yung kanyang base value, or yung initial value niya nung nag-start tayong mag-track ng index. And calculation frequency, so our index gets updated every minute. And the way it is computed is based on the free float market capitalization of the member companies. Under review frequency, so nakalagay dito is semi-annual. So this means there's a committee under PSE which decides to update the PSE member companies if necessary. So every 6 months, pwedeng magbago, pwedeng magdagdag ng company or magbawas ng company doon sa members ng ating index. And this is actually very important because we have to remember may mga funds which follow our index. So if a new company is added to the index, so yung mga fund managers will have to buy the same companies para ma-mirror nila yung index. So that means it's a good opportunity, at least in the short term. Now, if you want to see yung exact formula how the index is computed, so ito yung kanyang formula. We don't really need to do this calculation because again, we can easily get the exact figures of these indices sa PSE website or in our trading platform. And with this basic information, so we now understand that when we hear in news or other media coverages where they say that the market is up or down for a given day, so we know that they are actually talking about our main index, which is PSEI, and not really a specific company. And speaking of our index, we also have a variation of PSEI, which is called PSEI Total Return Index. And we can see here yung comparison of the performance of these two indices. So yung main index, PSEI, only covers price appreciation ng mga member stocks. But yung second index, yung Total Return Index, covers both price appreciation and income from dividend payments by reinvesting these cash dividends. So Total Return Index. So cover niya yung both price appreciation and yung dividends. So in this chart, we can see that our index actually grows over time. So paakyat baba yan, paakyat baba, but the long-term trend is paakyat. And this is expected because remember, our index gets updated every 6 months. So meron siyang semi-annual review, and this review ensures that the index reflect the performance of the best stocks in the stock market that we have as a whole and in its sectors. And that's actually the premise of index investing. So itong chart na ito yung dahilan why people do index investing, because again, it grows over time. And yan yung ating next na pag-uusapan, which is index investing. So when we talk about index investing, again, the whole idea is we want to ride on the growth of our index by mirroring or copying its composition. So meaning to say, if yung index has, for example, 15% return after a year, we would want our money to also have the same return after the same period of time. So that's what we meant with investing in the index or buying the index. So we simply follow the stocks covered by it. For example, if ang composition index is 16% SM, 6.8% Ayala Corporation, and 8% Ayala Land, so if you will do index investing, your stock portfolio should also have the same composition. And if makapagbigay ng ROI na 12% yung index, then that will also translate to the same ROI for your portfolio because kinokopya mo lang siya. And from here, we can see the advantages when we do index investing. So first advantage by design is the index is diversified. So because it is a group or a basket of assets, our investment is not too exposed in one company or sector. So meron siyang stocks from financials, from consumer, from property development, etc. And this is clearly a form of proper risk management. Second advantage is it can be profitable over time. So if we look at this next chart, so this is tracking our PSE index. So hindi siya straight na paakyat. But if we look at this historical performance, so if you have a long-term horizon, umakyat yung ating index through the years. And the reason again is by design, the index composition is reviewed constantly or semi-annually. So pag may mga lumulutang na magagandang company sa market, so sinasama nila yun sa index. And similarly, if meron siyang member company na not performing really well, so tinatanggal nila yun sa PSE member list. So in short, at any period in time, our index PSEI contains the biggest companies we can invest in. Finally, it's a classic passive way of investing. So this is very ideal for non-professional investors like employees and active businessmen. And it is obviously passive because again, as investors, you don't need to do the hard work of finding kung ano ba yung mga stocks that you will buy. So you will simply check the composition of the index and copy the member stocks and their percentage weights and do the same sa portfolio mo. So si PSE na mismo ang nag-a-update ng index and you simply mirror it onto your portfolio over time. So yun yung 3 advantages when investing in an index. So it's diversified, it is profitable over time, and it is passive. Very minimal time lang yung kailangan mo. So after we talk about advantages, now let's talk about the risks of doing index investing. And the main risk really is since you are invested for the long term, you are exposed to market crashes. So for example, this chart shows the historical growth of our index. So this is from 1988 up to year 2020. And while it is true that our index has grown a lot after many years, you could be a victim of market crashes if you have a short-term horizon. So for example, in year 1997, we have 1997 Asian financial crisis. So down yung market niya ng around 60%. And then in year 2008, we had the global financial crisis. So down yung market niyan or yung index ng almost 50%. And then today, we have the 2020 crash due to COVID-19 pandemic. So if nag-invest ka just before these market crashes and maiksi lang yung time horizon mo, then you would have lost a lot with this market crash. So maraming short-term traders ang affected with this kind of market movement. But if you're into investing for more than 10 years or 20 years, so you could wait it out. And as we can see naman here in this chart, it would most likely recover. So medyo matitest lang talaga yung patience mo and risk tolerance. Kasi makikita mo yung portfolio mo na down ng 40 to 60%. So those are the advantages and risks when you do index investing. And one main challenge here is if you do this index investing manually, mahirapan ka because you will need to purchase 30 stocks at minimum board lot each. And pag ginawa mo yun, malaking capital yung kakailanganin mo. But fortunately, we have alternatives to do index investing even with small capital. And yun actually yung i-discuss natin. So how to invest in an index. But before we continue, so if you are enjoying this video and want us to make more videos more often, then please hit the thumbs up button and subscribe to show your support. Also, if you have questions or thoughts while watching this video, then please do share it in the comment section below. So going back to how you can invest in an index, so essentially we have 2 ways to do this. So first is buying a mutual fund and second is by investing in an exchange traded fund or ETF. So first we discuss what is a mutual fund. So pwede nyo panoorin yung ating previous video discussing in more details what a mutual fund is. But essentially, A mutual fund is also just a basket of investments. And then meron yung fund manager, which decides what companies will comprise the fund. For example, it could be a fund that is heavily invested in biggest companies that we have like Jollibee, SM, Ayala Corporation, etc. And then meron yung tinatawag na net asset value. So ito ngayon yung pinakapresyo ng mutual fund kapag mag-i-invest ka. And it is issued by mga tinatawag nating investment companies or mutual fund companies. And in the Philippines, we have several investment companies or mutual fund providers. So ito yung some of the biggest name, ATRAM, ALFM, we have FAMI, Philam Asset Management, Phil Equity, and Sun Life. And you can get the entire list of all other mutual fund providers sa website na pfar.com.ph. And depende sa goals and time horizon ng fund and nung investors doon, the mutual funds that these mutual fund providers give can be classified into four types. So we have money market, which is mainly invested in short term, 1 year or less na debt instruments. We have bond fund type of mutual fund. So ang laman naman nito is mga long term debt instruments of governments or corporations. And then we have the third type, which is yung balanced fund. So it's a combination of shares of stock and debt instruments. And finally, yung pinaka-aggressive is yung stock funds na type of mutual fund which is invested primarily in shares of stocks or equity. And when we talk about stock funds, pwede pa actually natin yung hatiin into two subtypes. So we have the actively managed fund and we have the passively managed stock fund. So actively managed, meaning the fund manager decides which stocks to buy or sell para maisama sa fund. So yung fund manager is on its own and usually yung name of this type of mutual fund has the word equity or stocks. Mamaya may mga example tayo. And then yung second type naman is yung passively managed. So here yung fund manager only mirrors or copies the index composition kung ano man yung sinusundan niya. So meaning to say wala siyang masyadong analysis na ginagawa because again kinakopy niya lang kung ano man yung nangyayari dun sa index. And because of this, yung mga common names ng mga passively managed funds ay may term na index mutual funds. So for example, under actively managed, pwedeng si First Metro may in-offer siyang tinatawag na First Metro Save and Learn Equity Fund, INC. And then under passively managed, meron din siyang in-offer na First Metro Save and Learn Philippine Index Fund. Okay, and then other mutual fund providers, meron din silang sariling actively managed like Phil Equity Fund. And then under passively managed, meron siyang Phil Equity PSE Index Funds. And then for Sun Life, meron silang Sun Life Prosperity Philippine Equity Fund. And then yung corresponding passively managed is Sun Life Prosperity Philippine Stock Index Fund. So from the name of the fund itself, you will already have an idea whether the fund is actively managed or passively managed. So just to summarize, so again, what is an index mutual fund? So it's a fund that passively mimics an index. And then by design, it owns the same securities that are included in the benchmark index. And as a result, if the underlying securities of the index increase in value, so yung mutual fund or yung index fund will become correspondingly more valuable and vice versa. So to illustrate, in this chart, we have our PSE index colored yellow. So ito yung ating main index. And then yung blue chart is the performance of an actual index mutual fund. So ito yung under kay Philippine Equity or Phil Equity PSE Index Fund. And as you can see, yung line chart nila have almost the same performance, which is expected. And if you look at the numbers, so ito siya. So every year, magkakalapit lang yung returns niyan because again, yung ating mutual fund na index fund in this case is just copying kung ano man yung composition ng ating market index. And the nice thing is you can invest online in a mutual fund and this slide shows you yung flow of money when investing in a mutual fund. So this is you with extra money at hand. So hanap ka lang ng stock broker and then again through the online stock broker, bibili ka ngayon ng mutual fund. So ang pipiliin mo is mutual fund company and kung ano yung type na mutual fund, whether active or passive or bond or market type mutual fund. Then after some time, so you can sell and hopefully you get your money back with some decent profits. So this is you and then ito yung iyong broker and then ito yung mutual fund and then this is you using the same broker to sell and you get your money back. And the nice thing is you can now invest in a mutual fund online because there are now online stock brokers that can help you do it. And some of those names are here. So meron Call Financial, FundSmart, and meron ding Rapver Financials. So check nyo na lang yung website nila. And pwede nyo rin panoorin, no, yung ating previous video that will help you find the best performing mutual fund based sa kanilang historical performance. So that's so much with the mutual fund as a way to invest or buy the index. And again, the second way to do this is to buy an ETF or exchange traded fund. So what is an exchange traded fund? So an ETF is actually very similar to a mutual fund because it is also a basket or a group of securities, except that you can buy and sell these through a stock exchange. So hindi ka lalapit sa mutual fund companies kung hindi papasok ka lang sa stock exchange through a broker. So if we go back, in mutual fund, a mutual fund is bought through a broker from an investment or a mutual fund companies. Now, ETF almost behaves the same way. So it's also a basket of securities. So it's also an investment fund. But this one is bought and sold in a stock exchange to a broker. So it acts like a normal stock in terms of trading, but it's a basket of assets. So that's really the one main difference. Again, an ETF is an investment fund intended to track an index or a basket of securities. And it is traded in a stock exchange. So kaya siya tinatawag na exchange traded fund. And therefore, meron siyang sariling market price. And meron tayong several types of ETFs. Under this is yung equity ETF, index ETF, commodity. Meron din tayong industry, currency, and foreign market ETFs. So there are several countries who offer lots of ETFs to the general public. In fact, there are more than 1,900 ETFs around the world. But in the Philippines, we only have one, which is the First Metro Philippine Equity ETF. So it's an index type of ETF which tracks our PSE index. And yung kanyang stock code is this one, so FMETF. And if you look at the code, so you will see its price and board lot just like any other stock. So in this case, ang price niya is 90 pesos and 55 centavos. And then ang kanyang board lot is 10. Meaning to say, you can already buy 10 shares of FMETF with around 1,000 pesos. Diba? So that's 90.55 times 10. So that's more than 900 pesos. And that would already be a form of investing in our index. So just check the updated quotes of our FMETF because this gets updated during market open. And because this also just copies yung ating index, as expected, parehas lang dapat yung performance nito with our index. That is actually shown in this next slide. So in this chart, yung purple line chart is our FMETF. And then yung blue line is our PSE index. So you can see talagang magkadikit lang talaga sila. So to summarize, here's a quick comparison of FMETF and mutual funds. So both of them are a basket of assets. And under index mutual funds, so these are bought from and sold to mutual fund companies. Whereas yung ETF are traded like stocks in a stock exchange. And then si mutual fund meron siyang entry and management fees. Whereas si ETF meron siyang PSE transactions, so yung mga buy and sell transaction fees, and meron din siyang management fees. And then si mutual fund meron siyang minimum holding period, normally yan mga 90 days. Whereas si equity ETF, you can buy and sell it anytime when the market is open. So yun yung kagandahan niya, pwedeng kapag kumita na siya, pwede mo na siyang ibenta kung gusto mo. And sa mutual fund, meron siyang starting amount which depends on the fund company. So pwede yung mga 1,000 pesos or 5,000 pesos. Whereas si ETF, so the amount that you will need depends on the ETF price and the board lot. And yung nakita natin kanina, pwede ka nang mag-invest sa index through ETF with as low as below 1,000 pesos. And finally, what strategy you can use when you do index investing? Again, one thing we just have to remember is index investing is really for the long term. So you can accumulate it, you can do buy and hold. Pwedeng mag-focus ka lang sa index or magbili ka lang ng FMETF and let it grow over time. Or you can also do a variation. So for example, you can do what we call a core satellite investing strategy. So basically here you have a core passive position. So let's say this could be your index fund or your FM ETF. And then meron kang stock picks, which is what we call satellites. So ito ngayon yung actively managed na gagawin mo. So these stock picks are essentially your high conviction stocks na tinatawag. Na sa tingin mo, you have market intelligence or you have confidence that this stock will perform really well. So meaning to say it will beat the index. So your core position, you can invest again in a mutual fund or FM ETF. And the good thing is you can do this kay Call Financial and kay First Metro Securities because they offer both stocks and mutual fund in one platform. So for example, you can do 50-30-20. So yung 50% ng holdings mo ay sa index fund or FM ETF. And then yung isang stock na pipiliin mo is 30%, the other one is 20%. Or pwede rin namang 60-20-20. So ikaw bahala yung mag-allocate nun. So ano yung benefit nito? Well, number one, because your core position is heavily invested sa index fund or ETF, so walang masyadong cost because again, walang masyadong buy and sell na nangyayari. Second is reduced volatility because you are invested in a diversified index. So hindi malaki yung talon ng presyo ng mga stocks mo because these are the biggest companies and hindi naman very volatile yung galawan ng mga malalaking companies that we have in our market. And then third is the opportunity to outperform the index. So yun actually yung role ng stock picks mo or yung satellites mo. So you will use it to outperform the index. And finally, this is perfect for anyone who wants to be more active in their investing because you can learn a lot about stock picking and trading. Yet at the same time, hindi ka masyadong exposed sa potential losses. Because again, bulk of your investment is nasa index fund or nasa FM ETF. Okay? So that actually ends our lesson for today. I hope nakatulong ito when it comes to your long-term investment. And again, if you like this video, then please hit the thumbs up button. Make sure to subscribe and click the notification bell so that you get updated for our future lessons. Also, if you have questions or comments related to this video or anything about stock market and investing, then please leave them in the comments section below. So thank you again guys for watching and see you in our next video. God bless us all. Bye-bye.